Ooh, yeah!
What's going on, peoples? This be your boy Smith with another Transformers super awesome review. And today we'll be looking at Transformers Generations Sandstorm. Before we get into the figure, let's take a look at the packaging. Here we have Sandstorm. He is Transformers Generation, part of the Thrilling 30s. Not much on the side. He is a Series 2. Number 3 of that series. Here are some tech specs: aircraft mode, doom buggy mode, robot mode, and there's his bio. If you want a quick read, go right ahead. That's pretty much it. He came with instructions, no card, but we're not here for all that. Let's get into the real meat and potatoes. Here we have Sandstorm. Like I said, this is the Thrilling 30s generation line. He is a remold of the Springer, which is a good thing because Springer is a pretty sweet robot. So he's already started off on the right foot. Now, I will say this about this figure. He's also a pretty decent triple changer, but I'm more of a fan of his aircraft mode than his actual vehicle mode, because this is supposed to be a doom buggy. But to me, it just kind of looks like a car with big wheels on the back. It doesn't really scream doom buggy. But they tried, you know. Like I said, it's a remold. There's a lot of different remolding to it. There are similarities to Springer, but they did add a lot of different extra variants to change him up significantly. Just for a quick comparison, here he is with Generation Springer. Now, as you can see, they did a lot of remolding for each figure. Like I said, they're pretty much the same. Transformation is somewhat similar. There are some slight differences just due to the extra remolding, but they are pretty much the same all intents and purposes. But this looks good in his car mode, and his helicopter mode's okay as well. But I'm not crazy about the car mode, but I do like his aircraft mode, which we'll get into in just a minute. But as you can see, get a quick close-up. Like I said, there's a lot of remolding, and there's still some similarities. The wheels are pretty much the same, except for he's got green rims, he's got silver. The bumpers are different. And like I said, they did a lot of remolding in the back because, like I said, he's got the bigger wheels, so they had to change that up. But there's still some components to each one of these guys that are the same and some that are a little bit different. But all in all, they're both pretty good figures. Like I said, he's the sexier one, but he's not that far behind. He's a good-looking figure, especially in his robot mode. It definitely looks good. I like him. That's why he's in my collection, because I liked his robot mode. His vehicle modes, like I said, one I like and one I really like, but I really like the robot mode, so we'll get to that. You had your chance. You had your time to shine. This is his turn. But like I said, this is doom buggy mode. Looks really good. He does come with a gun that you can prop on top of the vehicle if you want to do. Just like Springer, it is friction loaded, not spring loaded, so you press down. And this one doesn't seem to work that well. We'll try that again. See if we can get something. There we go. So like I said, it's nice. There's no springs, no nothing. It's just basically a friction. So you don't have those like kind of hair triggers where it just goes off in moments notice, or you accidentally brush against the trigger. You really gotta put some friction to it to set it off. So that's cool. And also has the kind of tilt on it. So if you want to prop it up on there, so you can get kind of a, you know, but like me personally, I don't display my figures in vehicle mode. And if I did, I wouldn't prop a gun on top of them. It just looks silly to me. So I'm not going to do that. But like I said, if you want to do that, you go right ahead. You do what makes you happy. Now, let's get this guy into his aircraft mode, which again, like I said, it's pretty similar to Springer's. A little bit different of a variation, but if you saw my last review, you kind of want to follow those almost exact same steps with just a few differences. But let's get into it, shall we? Let's raise this up a little bit. How I'm going to do it is I'm going to start here, pull out these tabs, just basically bring them around, cover up those front wheels. Do that for this side. Next thing you can do is you can take this part and just kind of pull that off for now. You'll want to, again, there's a slot and a tab there, and you basically kind of want to pull that out so you can get that first arm loose. Do the same for the other end. And at the same time, you will detach the chest right there. Now, we can leave that there for now. Take the legs, and basically you'll pull the wheels up on each side, and then take the legs and just basically flip them all the way to the front, or flip them together, actually, I mean to say. And you'll have that. Now, next what you'll want to do is take this cockpit area, cockpit, there we go, and basically untab it from the back here, and you're going to want to bring it to the forward, this slot right there, tab down there, and just basically bring it up and tab it into there. There we go. Next thing you'll do is flip this around and then bring down these side windows. Just close them in. Same on the other side. Flip it around. Close that in. Next part is you will bring your chest. Raise it up some. Bring the chest down. Both sides. Now there is a tab here. Slot in the arms. It's kind of like... tab those in to keep them in place. And then what you'll do next is there is a slot there and a tab there, and you'll want to tab those in to keep that in place as well. See there? Now they're tabbed in. Then you'll basically just bring your tail down, and it's kind of on a double hinge, so you kind of want to bring it down a little bit. And then there is a slot there and there, and you have two tabs there, and you want to tab that in. And you kind of want to angle the legs up a little bit to make that connection possible too, so keep that in mind. Sometimes it's not the trickiest thing to do, but it's gotta angle it just right to get it tabbed in. See if I can get it. There we go. And then once you tab it in, last but not least, just flip those wheels around to reveal his propellers. And I think that's about it. Then you can put down the landing gear. There's one on the front as well. And there you have him in his aircraft mode. And like I said, I personally like the aircraft mode better than the Doom Buggy. Don't ask me why, I just do. I think it looks really good. Almost kind of reminds me of one of those crafts in Avatar or something, but it looks really good. I mean, they definitely did some sweet engineering when it came to remolding this figure. and you can see the hints of Springer in him, but he also is his own figure. So like I said, they took this one mold and definitely made it work. That's, like I said, why I like this figure as well as the Springer, because even though they're slightly the same, they have their own individuality and it works. Now, for a quick comparison, I will take a look at, bring Springer in his helicopter mode, and we'll take a look at those two together. And here we have Springer in his helicopter mode, and as you can see, the difference in those two forms as well. Like I said, he's a little slimmer. He's got a little more beef on top of him due to the whole wheels here, which, like I said, definitely separates them. You know, you wouldn't really know that these were the exact same molds, but they are. But they do it so well to give themselves their own individuality. You know, he's a helicopter, and he's more of just like an aircraft, even though technically in G1, he was also a helicopter. But I guess they figured they didn't want to just give us the same exact mold, so they had to do something to kind of break it up, which is cool, and I like that. I definitely like that. Now, the same as Springer, you can attach the gun to the bottom of the craft. I still don't know how to do it, and I sat here and I tried. I honestly tried, and I can't do it. If someone can show me or let me know, leave a comment down below, but honestly and truthfully, I don't care. Like weapons on the vehicle is not an issue for me, so it's not gonna affect me that much. So, but anyway, Springer, Sandstorm, like I said, they both look good. I like his helicopter mode as much as I like the car mode. I like his aircraft mode. I'm okay with his dune buggy mode. Like I said, it's not definition of a dune buggy, but like I said, I understand. So I'm not butthurt about it, but it's cool. Let's get this guy out here. All right, let's get to the next phase of this guy right here, and that would be his robot mode. So we can basically kind of take it from here in his aircraft mode, and we can get to the robot mode real easily. So basically what you're going to do is you can untab that. Just leave that there for now. Take his feet, prop him up, pull out the heels. Lift up his knee pads, untab the arms. What you do is open this up here so you can pull out the fists. Close that back up. Same on this side. And next thing you'll want to do is take your head. Bring it up. I remember this time to leave the landing gear out so I have that clearance. And basically bring the chest, close that up, take this part here, pop it back down, and then what you'll do is you'll flip this whole section, and there's a slot there, the tab there, and you just tab that in. And then this part, really, you can pretty much do what you want. I mean, in the instructions, it'll have it up like this. But I don't like that, so we'll just... Hold on, let me raise him up real quick, because he's all low to the ground. You guys can't see that well, so let me prop this up a little bit for you. There we go. Take the chest, bring it up. Slot there, tab there, let's tab it in, and last but not least, actually, I think, oh, wait, did I do that right? Actually, no, I did it wrong, a little bit wrong. instead of doing like Springer bringing this down, you'll actually want to keep that up. So let's bring that back up, then tab that in. There we go. Now we've right. You know, sometimes you got to go back and look again, because sometimes everybody's bound to make mistakes, you know. Nobody's perfect, but just had to think about that for a minute. So, and then I think that'll be it. And here we have Sandstorm in his robot mode. And, oops, there we go, fix those legs. There we go. And he looks really good. I definitely dig this figure. He is all kinds of BA. The way he looks, like I said, you really wouldn't know he was the same mold as Springer, because there's so much different in the robot mode, but there's so much of Springer in him. But the way they put it together, just like I said, I keep saying the word, give them their own individuality. It's just so, like, cool. Like, I definitely dig this figure. I definitely dig him. And part of that is, look at that. I mean, Springer's got some sweet light piping, but this dude right here, man, I mean, look at that. That is some beastly light piping right there. I mean, come on. And look at the face. Just the face itself is just, I mean, honestly and truthfully, yeah, it's more IDW, but his G1 counterpart, I really think couldn't even hold a candle to this guy. Like, he's definitely a certified BA, if you ask me, and I really dig him. Like, look at that, like, everything on him, the paint apps look good, just the molded detail to him is just, everything about him is just really, really good. I definitely am glad to have this guy in my collection. And he looks really good. Like, especially, like, I always pose him next to Springer, because they just, like, they seem like they would be kind of a tandem team together. And they really work together. It really does. Now, just for a quick comparison, I will bring out Springer so we could take a look at these two sexy beasts together. And I will go out and say it. You know, I say Springer is sexy. This guy's pretty sexy too. Like I said, he's got it going on. He's definitely got it going on in spades. I will give him his props where props is due, because he is definitely a good looking figure. But let me bring out Springer, so we can have ourselves a quick comparison. And I don't know, he has kind of issues with standing a little bit. I don't know if it's my figure, but it's like almost, there it is. See, that's my problem. I didn't have his legs locked in completely, so he wasn't, he couldn't stand, but now I think we got it. Yeah, we got it. So let me bring out Springer and we'll take a look at these beefcakes together. And here he is with Springer. And as you can see, this is quite a dynamic duo right here. And like I said, they look really good. And they look really good on my shelf. I like I said, there's not much I can really say bad about either figure. I like this dude. And like I said, you can just see from here how strong the light piping is on this guy. It's like, we're not even that close to the camera, and he's just shining. Springer's has got his, but due to his head sculpt, it doesn't come out as much, but it's just as good. But, like, his is just, it's just full-on just light piping. It's amazing. And like I said, you can see the similarities, the foot a little bit. They both have their knee pads, similar crotch areas, but just repainted, and then the arms. Other than that, and chest. Other than that, everything else is pretty much remolded. Like, you know, except for these foot, crotch, That's the only similarities they have, that and the arms. Everything else is remolded, so that's like pretty impressive. This is two totally different figures. You know, we get a lot of, you know, especially dealing with Combiner Wars, you got a lot of figures that are just the same mold with different paint apps and maybe a different head. You know, not a lot of remolding got done. But this right here, this is how it should be done. If you're going to take one mold and make two figures, you better make them look totally different to the point where I want to spend my money to buy the exact same figure again. Because that's basically what I did, but I don't see it looking at these two guys as the same figure because they're not. There's nothing about them outside of their transformation that is the same. And that's the way it should be done. If you're going to do a remold, this is how you do a remold. Right here. Yeah, right there. And yeah, good looking figure. Definitely dig him. Give him, I think I'm going to have to give him a 4.5 as I gave Springer, because he's got fun factor, decent light piping. As far as articulation, 360, I think it's on, it might be on a ball joint. So yeah, you get up this much, got down this much, the full 360. Arms, you can get out to about there. He can go 360, but due to his wings, can't really, kind of hinders him. Got ratcheted elbows, give you 90 degrees. Does have a bicep swivel. Has a waist swivel. Nice, not loose, very tight. Got thigh swivel. Legs, you'll definitely get a full split. Get you out here. Go back that much. And then you got a nice ratchet in knee at 90 degrees. Got a bit of a foot tilt up, back. No rocker. But again, because of just the amount of posability he possesses, you kind of don't need it because his foot, honestly and truthfully, it's already on. If you can see, it's on a slant. So you kind of, it gives you that reason to kind of give him that action pose. So, kind of makes up for not having a rocker. But yeah, definitely, definitely a good figure. His hands are in a solid mold, and like I said, he can hold it like a champ. Doesn't come with any sword or anything. He's just got the one weapon. So, you know, I'm cool with that. And he just looks good doing it as well. So yeah. Do I recommend this guy? Yes, I do. 4.5 out of 5. He definitely deserves that score. Is he a sexy beast? Yes, he is. Just like his boy Springer. Like I said, they're two peas in the same pod. So, yeah, I called Springer a sexy bot. I got to call him a sexy bot because he's definitely good looking. I like him. He's different. And like I said, I don't know what happened between then and now when it came to their figures. I don't know. Like I said, I like Titans Return. I like Combiner Wars. But why do I feel this line is the better line, and it's an older line? You would think it only gets better afterwards. You know, I hate to sound like I'm bad-mouthing the newer models that's out there, but as good as they are, they're not as good as this. And I'm confused. You know, maybe it's just me. I could be wrong. If you think I'm wrong, leave a comment. You know, it's open for discussion. I'm not afraid of a little debate, but I digress. 4.5 out of 5. Definitely get this guy. If you don't already have him, I highly recommend you pick him up. He is, just like Springer, he is still available. So you can't say I can't find this guy, because I found this guy. So I'm pretty sure you can find this guy. In fact, Big Bad Toy Stores, I see him all the time on that site. I think he's still available. In fact, if he is, I will leave a link in the description down below. And as always, if you want to follow me on Twitter, Google Plus, or my Facebook fan page. I'll leave a link in the description down below for that. And as always, I like to thank you guys for coming to my channel. I'm almost at 50 subscribers. I've been doing this now for about a month or so, and I am feeling the love. I am definitely feeling all the feedback that I get from you guys. And like I said, I got a lot of new things coming down the way. And I'm looking forward to hopefully soon hitting 100 and 200 and so on and so forth. And I hope you guys will continue to enjoy the ride and join me for this adventure that we call Transformers. Because, like I said before, it's a good time. It is a really good time to be a Transformers fan. With so many options and just so much out there, like, this is the time to be a Transformers fan. And with that being said, for Sandstorm, it's be your boy Smith. And as always, keep it greasy, keep it easy, and I'm rolling out. Peace.